A big thank you to GoDaddy for sponsoring this video. GoDaddy Managed WordPress Hosting is a great way to quickly create and host your WordPress site. Go to bit.ly/JamieWP to get 30% off your Managed WordPress Hosting today. So I've been walking around for the last 6 months with this idea just buzzing in my head, and whatever I do, I can't dispel it. I go out and it's in my head again. I go online and it's in my head again. I just can't get the idea out of my head. So today I'm going to show you what it is, and I want you to tell me what you think, either by commenting in the comments below or give the video a thumbs up if you think this is a good idea. It's one of those ideas that may be terrible, but I think it seems so obvious to me, as somebody that's taught WordPress beginners for the last about 12 years now, that this idea would absolutely fly in the WordPress market. Let me show you what it is. So the big idea is that a WordPress beginner, somebody with absolutely no website building experience, could log into their WordPress website, as you see on the screen here, and immediately, with zero learning curve, start building out beautiful web pages. So they don't have to understand CSS grid, they don't have to understand Flexbox, they don't have to add containers into pages and columns into pages. They literally drag and drop the elements around on the page as they see them to design everything. And what's more, it's going to be built right on top of Gutenberg, so when you exit easy mode, everything will be available as core Gutenberg blocks with all the controls you get in Gutenberg. Okay, confession time. That prototype that you just saw wasn't real. I actually built it using Canva's website builder. Before you roll your eyes at me using Canva as an example of how to do it, let me give you some amazing stats that are just going to blow your mind. So I think this is interesting because Canva point the way to the huge opportunity that is the beginner's market, because Canva is a zero learning curve tool. You don't need to know anything. You just pick it up and use it. So here's some stats for you. So currently Canva has 150 million monthly users. Now the current population of the UK, I think, is about 67 million. So Canva has over twice the amount of people using it than are currently in the UK population. Boom, that's mind-blowing. Current revenue, 2023, they posted revenue of 1.7 billion and they are profitable. I think these next two stats are really interesting, especially for WordPress, because WordPress has a demographic problem, both in terms of sex and age. So currently 55% of all users that use Canva are female, 34% of users are aged between 25 and 34. So there is a whole cohort of people coming up that have been trained on these zero learning curve tools that are using Canva. Then we have a valuation of 40 billion. I'm not sure how accurate that one is. That's the number I gleaned off the internet, but they're a private company, so that's debatable, but it's still a huge valuation. And then this next stat is there are 2 million websites have been built just with the beta version of the website builder that I stole from my little prototype at the start. Now, I don't know how many websites have been built since then because they haven't published that information, but that is a big number. So on the one hand, Canva have demonstrated to us that there's this absolutely enormous beginner's market. And on the other hand, we have the current state of the WordPress page builder market, which from my perspective, are not really talking to beginners. So a useful exercise is to zoom out and take a look at the beginner's market. Now, when I talk about a beginner, I'm talking about somebody that goes to WordPress for the very, very, very first time. They have no experience of web design. They don't understand CSS grid. They don't understand Flexbox. They have no comprehension about CSS. They just want to build a website. So what we've got here is the standard business access. We've got hard to use over on the left, then we've got easy to use over on the right. The easier something is, the more it comes over here. Then we've got lots of functionality going up north on this axis, and then we've got limited functionality down here. And it's really interesting, if you plot the current state of page builders through the eyes of a complete WordPress beginner, which is a huge, huge, huge market. It's a massive market. So let's do it. Let's do it now. So I'm going to start with bricks. Bricks is here. I would put bricks right in the top left. So it's really hard for a beginner with no web experience at all to use, almost impossible, but it has lots of functionality. Then let's move on to Elementor. I would say it's a little bit easier to use than bricks out of the box for a beginner. Still really hard though. It has lots of concepts that beginners won't understand. There is definitely a learning curve. Then we've got things like Oxygen. Then we've got Breakdance. Then we've probably got divi here. Notice how they're all congregating in this hard to use. Now remember, I'm talking about a complete WordPress beginner. There is a learning curve around all these tools. Then we've got Gutenberg. Gutenberg, a bit easier to use, probably a bit less functionality out of the box than some of these page builders, but it's still up in this left-hand quadrant. Gutenberg still has some concepts that are really, really hard for beginners to understand, especially when we start talking about block themes and templates and template parts and patterns and all that stuff. It's really complex. And I'm saying there's a massive opportunity for somebody to build a product that fits over here in this top right quadrant. This is the massive market opportunity. This is where the beginners hang out, and this is what I think somebody could build. This plugin, this page builder, would have zero learning curve. So you wouldn't have to understand anything about web design. It would all be drag and drop, but under the bonnet, it would actually be using Gutenberg. Look, tell me I'm crazy. Tell me I'm crazy, and I'll stop banging on about this, and this will make my life a lot easier because I'll just stop thinking about it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Am I mad? Is nobody seeing this enormous opportunity? Have I got this completely wrong? Let me know in the comments, and I'll stop obsessing about it at 3 o'clock in the morning or when I'm out walking on the hills. Let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching. I really want to hear your comments though, so let me know in the comments below. If you think it's a good idea, hit that like button as well, because that's a good signal to me. It also helps share the video, and also every time you do hit that like button, our cats get a little treat. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found that one interesting. Again, let me know what you think. Keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.